Hey folks, welcome to the Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. In today's episode, something cool that one of my Patreon members turned me on to, so I figured I would show you guys. This is specifically if you're heat treating stainless steel between plates. One of the problems is cooling down those plates between batches of knives can be a big pain in the butt. This is an excellent tool, so let's check it out. So one of my Patreon members, Will from Maine, turned me on to this. These are basically just pieces of aluminum that have channels drilled into them and then ports that you can put this plastic tubing in. And I just bought two of them. They're about a half inch thick, and I think they're about 8 inches long, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, 8 inches long. My quench plates are 4 inches wide, so this fits just perfectly. So, what you're gonna do is, I'm gonna put some ice water. I've got this submersible pump that I paid, I think, $11 for. Put it in the water, it'll pump this, and then it'll just go back into here. And I wanna see how cold these are gonna get. So I'm gonna get my heat gun, test these, and we'll see how cold we can get them before any of the setup. Okay, so let's just test. It's pretty warm in here right now, so it's reading about 80 degrees, which is probably pretty accurate. I'm just gonna test on my hand here. Yeah. 98 degrees, so it's pretty accurate. So now I'm gonna put the pump in here and run it for a couple of minutes and then test the temperature. So I've had it running for about a minute. They are really cold, certainly in the 40s. This temp gun, don't think it's calibrated enough to go that low because it is certainly lower than 65, 64 degrees. Yeah, I'm thinking in the 30s. So we'll try this on the plates because the plates will certainly heat up quite a bit. But yeah, these are really, really cold. Like almost, they feel like ice. Okay, I've just removed the knives, and I'm gonna use this as a control. So right now, this is at 127 degrees. So I'm gonna blow this off with compressed air for 3 minutes, and I'm gonna see what temp I can get this down to. Right now it's, yeah, it's really hot. It might even be hotter than 127. So I've blown it off for about 2.5 minutes. Yeah, it's still at 118 degrees. So that's still pretty hot. I'm gonna put the these in here and see what that's gonna do. So after about 20 seconds, I'm already down 10 degrees. That's pretty good. So it's been about a minute and these are already colder than room temperature. That's really, really cool. So I've just heat treated my second knife, but this time I didn't use any compressed air, and we're gonna see how fast I can cool this down. Yeah, it's definitely hot to the touch right now, and it's been 5 seconds. So you can see I set a timer. It's only been 50 seconds, and this is already cool to the touch. I'm gonna cool it right down, probably to around 50 degrees before I put the next set of knives in. And folks, if you need some stainless steel to put between those quench plates, check out Maritime Knife Supply. They have everything you need, from carbon steels to stainless steels, handle materials, and all the equipment to make beautiful knives. Go check them out. Links down in the description. So I've been thinking about this, and one of the downsides of putting a knife in here and using compressed air, it's
just a pain in the butt. It doesn't work very well. So I figured I'm going to take these off. I'm going to mill a channel on the top and the bottom, and I'm actually going to slide these in, turn this on while I clamp the blade. That will cool these down. I won't have to screw with compressed air anymore. So let's give that a shot. So here's the final setup. I've got these, right now they're just sitting in here in these slots. They do move back and forth. I was thinking maybe of just CA gluing them in place, but they're not really going to move. So I've got them wired to each other, and I've put zip ties here just so I don't hit this. If I slide something in here that's kind of long, I don't want to risk hitting these and melting them. And then, of course, the exhaust tube, and of course, I haven't plugged this one in yet because it's not quite long enough right now. But this will fix underneath my bench here, and I'm anxious to try it out because I think this is going to cool them really, really well. I'll try this out on another build because I've done all the heat treating that I need to do today, but I'm really happy with this. I think it's going to work perfectly. Thanks, folks. See you on the next one.